We are back in Utah and the kids have been dying to come shoot their guns. So we are going to do a really quick video on how to show your kids how to shoot guns safely and properly and the steps that we take, that I've taken with my kids so they understand gun safety and the importance of it, but we can still go shoot and have fun. Gage, what's the very first thing I ever taught you about guns?
Don't point them at people.
Very good. You don't ever want to point a gun at anything that you don't want to shoot. Okay, Bailey, what's something else I've always stressed to you?
Never touch a gun without parent supervision.
Yes, you never want to touch a gun or be around a gun without an adult around. I keep all my guns and all my ammunition locked away in a safe that kids can't get to. I have a key and they can't get to the guns without me around. Gun safety is very, very important. There's a lot of people that are killed every year by kids playing with guns without their parents around, and with parents leaving their guns around the house that aren't locked up and the kids have access to them. So I've always stressed that to the kids. Never point a gun at anybody or anything you don't want to shoot. Never play with the gun without anybody around. Never touch the ammunition. You always want an adult around. I feel very strongly about this, but I also feel very strongly about teaching kids to shoot a gun and to enjoy it. Even if you never hunt, the ability to shoot a gun is very important. Who knows when you might need to use a gun. Another very important thing is safety. You always want to have earplugs on of some sort. We like these ones because you can actually hear, but when you shoot, it deafens the sound of shooting, so you can actually hear what's going on, but it also deafens the sound. So when you are ready to shoot and you have an adult around, what you want to do is make sure you have a safe place to shoot. It has to be out of the city limits. It has to have a good backstop, and you have to be shooting at something, a target or an animal if you're hunting. But you always want to know where you're shooting and your surroundings, so because maybe there's somebody over the hill or a house or something. So you always want to have a good backdrop where your bullet's going to hit the dirt and it's going to stop there and not ricochet. And that's what we have here. We're going to shoot into this hillside at a box, at a target. So let's go ahead and shoot. We'll get set up, set the targets up, and we'll shoot. All right, so what we're going to use today is just a cardboard box. I drew a black box on it so the kids have something to aim at. Don't ever stick like rocks or anything inside the box or anything you're shooting at, because rocks will deflect a bullet and it will ricochet. I just threw some dirt in it to hold it. We've got a good hill back behind us so that we know the bullet will be penetrating into the dirt, not ricocheting over the top of the hill. So let's go back and shoot. You guys ready?
Yes.
Who's
yes.
gonna shoot first?
Me.
All right, let's do it. Now look through the hole. Can you see the hole? Can you see it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright guys, we have been shooting the box. These kids have both hit it probably 3 or 4 times a piece. They're doing good. So now we're going to have a little bit of fun and shoot something that's going to give us a little bit of action. You ready? You guys want to shoot it?
Yeah!
Okay, let's do it.
It's going to explode.
It's going to explode, hopefully. Just make sure you pick up all your crap after you're done, because it's nothing that makes me more mad than seeing people that shoot stuff and just leave it in the woods. Whatever you shoot, pick it up, take it home with you. Let's go blow this up, okay? Alright guys, we just wanted to show you what we like to do for fun. Every once in a while we love to come target shooting. The kids absolutely love to come shoot. This is actually a little 22 that we bought Braylee when she was 5 years old.
Four
years old. I got a little excited and bought her a 22 when she was 4. And this is going to be Gage's gun. This is a 22 Magnum I bought right before me and Kaylee were married, but this will be Gage's gun one day. So we just wanted to come out and show you guys a safe way to get the kids out and to learn how to shoot. These are just small caliber rifles. We don't hunt with these guns. They're just mostly for target practice. There is a way to teach your kids safety and yet responsibility when it comes to firearms. So you don't have to be afraid of them. You don't have to be terrified of them. There is a responsible and a safe way to handle a firearm and how and go out and practice with them and enjoy yourselves. Do you guys like shooting today?
Yes.
We shot some pretty cool stuff, huh?
Yeah. We shot a box. We shot a box. We shot cans.
A box. We shot cans. Did you shoot a can?
Yeah.
We shot a Dr. Pepper can.
It exploded.
And it exploded. Did you shoot a can?
Yes, and it exploded, like, clear up to the air.
I was very impressed. These kids shot very well. This is probably the fourth or fifth time they've been out shooting with me, and they're getting better. They're getting more comfortable with the gun. And all right, so we're going to go pick up all our trash. Like I was saying before, I hate when people leave all their junk out after they've shot. So go make sure if you shoot something, pick it up, throw it away, take it home. But make sure you guys, like I said, if you guys own firearms, keep them locked away from kids, and teach your kids not to touch them and not to play with them unless adults are around. All right, so thanks, guys, for watching, and maybe next time we'll be shooting a big elk together, right?
Yeah, or a bear.
Or a bear.
The call. The baddest of them all. If it ain't about money.